Hello and welcome to another episode of Minecraft Vanilla Superflat Survival. And I'm back in the overworld, so I'm going to show you basically the achievements that I made in the nether. I made a really awesome base down there, did some other work. I also mined up a bunch of netherrack, mined out. I also cut down some trees, I also expanded some fences, I also took some more materials, cut down a bit of the trees. Now unfortunately my other chicken glitched out as well, so that really sucks. Now I only have one chicken. I'm about to just drop all these chicken, I don't care, they're just too much work, they always glitch out. Maybe someday I can make a floating chicken farm oh, it just grew, wow, did you see that? I hope you did, because that was pretty awesome. I don't think I ever saw a baby chicken turn into a full-grown chicken. Well, I actually think that I'm going to stop messing with the chicken because they're just too much hassle, and until I can learn a good design on how to build a floating chicken farm, which is basically a chicken farm where the chicken are being pushed into the center with a stream of water. I'll just drop that by accident by pressing Q. Well, they're basically, like, pushed into the center by water streams, and that makes it basically impossible for them to glitch out. Oh, wow. How did so many witches just spawn? I mean, I was just here just a bit. Just a few minutes ago. Okay, let's hope we get some redstone from this. Let's really hope we get some. Oh, baby, a triple. Oh, my God. Okay, if we don't get redstone from this, this is gonna suck. Yeah, I think we did not get any redstone from that, unfortunately. We did get some glowstone dust, but that became largely useless now that we have access to the nether, where we have a much more reliable and better access to glowstone dust and stuff like that. Oh, we did actually manage to get an iron shovel from a zombie or something, so that's the good news. Okay, let me just set that down really quick. Okay, now I want to show you the progress that I made in the nether, so now I can fill up my nether items chest. This is how much netherrack I have currently mined out. I do have some more netherrack in the chest in my nether base. I'm gonna use these iron bars as windows on my nether base. Okay, let me just set down the axe right here. This is the wrong chest. Here's my broke tools, which are almost completely broke. I use this to just, when I get several broken tools that I don't want to take with me, that take up inventory space, that when I can craft more, I just place them in here, and when I have several of the same tools, I can craft them together and increase the durability of that, so. Okay, let me just craft some real quick. I'm gonna make another axe, just in case, because axes are important. Oh, just one piece right there. So, I also basically explored some more regions of the nether. I'm planning to find a nether fortress. This is also where I'm going to store lava. Now that I only have one bucket of lava, I can only carry one bucket of lava. And the next best thing to that is being able to store lava in, like, in this area right here. So, I can pour lava somewhere right here. And then basically have a lava pool right here. It actually looks like I don't need the last, I think, two of these. So, I think I'm going to break this up because I can't really reach it from right there. So, I'm just going to fill in a bit of dirt right here. Oh, no, not that one. So, this is where my... Okay, let me just place some torches right here just so no mobs would spawn. I'm really crazy on placing torches everywhere just to make sure no mobs spawn because I did saw a zombie walk by and burn up here the other day. So, okay, now I can reach in, and when I get some lava from the nether, which I will now get it from the nether because it's no use going around villages and collecting it, too much hassle. I'll just pour it in here and have a lava source, a bunch of lava sources here in which I can take the bucket. And I'll only have access to about one bucket. Unless I make an iron farm or find some more iron inside some blacksmith's chests. And now I'm going to go on to the nether. Now, for some reason, one little thing to mention is that for some reason, when it's loading terrain for the nether, sometimes Bandicam kind of lags out and skips my speech. So, I'll stay silent while it loads and transfers me to the nether so that it doesn't glitch out. Okay, going to the nether. there we go. So this is basically the base that I have made. I've lit it up fairly well. This is my nether portal right here. This is the edge of the lava right there. Now I'm gonna take some iron bars, place an iron bar right here. Just create some windows so I can just see. Oh crap. Yeah, that wasn't really efficient because I do apparently have my ladder right here, so I think I'll have to change my iron bar window to right here. Okay, that looks pretty nice. I think I'm gonna have a double window here just because of how amazing it looks outside here, so I'll just in case also have probably some windows right over here. But on the other hand, it doesn't really look good when it ends right here, like right into the door here, so I think I'll just have an iron bar right here. Oh yeah, that just destroyed one of the ladders that I had set up here. So okay, yeah, it does for some reason kind of lag out in the nether, which is weird. There are kind of some lag spikes, but other than that, we should be fine. Okay, we do have 4 more iron bars. I'm thinking that we could... Oh, yeah, we could also place one right here. And just possibly one right here just to keep track of our little passageway right here. Just maybe if we hear some pigmen walking around and we get suspicious, we could just look out and make sure that everything's fine over there. So now, when he have added the finishing touches, I have added some more torches up here. The reason I also have... I have also went to the overworld is to make some more torches and just fill up on more resources. I think I should also place some torches right here. Yeah, if you just saw that, there was a bit of lag spikes right there. So I did also put around some cobblestone right here just in case, because the ghasts can destroy the netherrack, and that way in case they destroy it, they cannot destroy the cobblestone, so that way if all of this gets destroyed, I will still have a platform to stand on. However, the ghasts can destroy my wooden doors, unfortunately, and I think I have seen them destroy my iron doors as well, so I gotta be careful for that. Okay, so now on to I'm gonna do some exploration missions right here. Oh, okay, let's get this thing moving. Okay, it should die soon enough. Oh, that was quick. I really like killing the ghasts, but I don't really get much out of it because I can't really collect their drops unless they're on top of any land. So I think right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to collect some of the glowstone right here. But to do that, I need some junk blocks, and the best junk blocks are, of course, the netherrack blocks. So I'm just going to take that. Set them over somewhere over here because I do need a platform to collect the glowstone on, because otherwise all of the glowstone will fall down into the lava, which is not in my interests. So maybe now we can finally get our whole squid tank filled up with glowstone. And some of my viewers probably remember that I do actually want to light up my squid tank and my lake that spawns squids. I want to light it up from the bottom and on the sides with glowstone to make it look cool, and just so I can see all the squid inside. And I haven't really gotten far with it because I don't really get much glowstone from witches. So I'm gonna get my glowstone from the nether from now on. But when I gain access to villagers, and when I get a villager breeder and all that good stuff, and a villager trading center set up, like an artificial one built by me, especially to trade, then I will get almost all of my glowstone from villager trading, because the villager priests have very great glowstone trades. So, and it is very efficient to trade, to buy glowstone with emeralds, because glowstone is such a rare and valuable resource, well, at least how I see it. And I can get the glowstone just by using some wheat, and I can just bone meal some wheat, sell it to a farmer for emeralds, get some emeralds from the farmers, then buy some glowstone blocks from the priests. So which is nice because I do need glowstone for potions and stuff like that. And also, I've been kind of thinking up for a use that I can do for the sugar that I have, and I was thinking, what can I really use the sugar for? There's not really much to do with sugar, but then I remembered that I can actually use sugar for... Ouch. I can actually use sugar for the potion recipe of a speed potion, and obviously in such a world like Superflat, we would need the speed potion to get around villages that are very far away from each other. And we would also need a speed potion because we can't really build high-speed boat systems everywhere, and it's much more economical to, and much more efficient to just use a speed potion to get around villages that are really far away from each other. Okay, let's just place some torches in replacement to the glowstone that lit this place up a while ago. Okay, looks like we got quite a bit of glowstone. Now, I won't craft this into... glowstone. Wow, that was a big lag spike. Now, I won't craft this right away into glowstone blocks, just in case I need this for potions. And like I said before, when I get my... it's much more economical to use speed potion of... speed potion 2 to get around villages that I don't get around very often. And the reason for that is I can't really build high-speed boat or rail transport systems everywhere, so if I want to get around a village that's kind of a village that I don't go to very often but I still need to get to it, or just exploring new villages, I can use a speed potion. So now step number 2 for me is going to be to collect some of the netherrack that's around here just for XP, and just because nether looks like a really beautiful block. I really like nether, so... I mean, nether quartz, so... we could craft some quartz block out of that, so... that would be great, and also used in some redstone builds. But of course, I do not have the redstone required to really do any redstoning with quartz, so... I don't think that's gonna be anytime soon, but... it is definitely nice to have quartz, so... it's something to collect. Okay, now let me get out of here. Fill that in, because this is an area that I walk around very often. Well, I think that my number one goal from now on is going to be actually to find, a nether fortress, because that's what I really need. I need blazes so I can get a potions, my potion stuff going. Okay, what just happened? That just glitched out. I gotta get my potions going. I gotta get a potion, stand thingy. I gotta get some stuff like that. And the way I'm gonna do it, I think, is I'm gonna go right here and just explore the general areas. I'm gonna put torches everywhere I go, and I've already explored this area. As you can see, I have a little bridge over here. I'm gonna use torches as my markers from now on. I'm gonna use different markers for different routes, so... I'm gonna try not to put torches too often, because that way I'm just gonna run out of torches too quickly. There are quite a bit of caves here, but I'm not really focusing on caves. I want to go to places that really have most of the open spaces. Okay, I don't know why it's just so glitchy and laggy when I place torches. How has placing torches become a resource-heavy thing? I don't know, but that is definitely weird. Okay, let me take some of these fires out. Okay, place some torches right here. Torches are especially great for geographical markers when it's dark because they emit light. Oh, wow, that's a lot of glowstone here. I'll collect all that later, but right now I'm just exploring. That's what I usually do. I usually just explore first, and then I collect the all of the stuff that I need. Oh, gravel. Okay, this one's gonna be an easy one. Okay, now I really hope that I can possibly... okay, is there lava there? Because... okay. Okay, it died. Now let's see, is there lava under there? Oh, wow. That's quite a bit of soul stone. I mean, soul sand. Okay, let me... put up some more torches right here just so I could know where to go back, because one of my worst fears is running off somewhere and exploring and then not being able to get home, and that would really suck. So I'll have to avoid that at all costs. Now let me try to somehow staircase down here so I would be able to have a good path here. It's great that I actually took my stone shovel because it's something that I could really use. Okay, now let's hope that we have some gas tiers. Oh no, just some more gunpowder. Well, I guess gunpowder will do. Well, we won't really need soul sand for a while unless we get nether warts, which we will probably get in the near future because... Hopefully in the near future because I really need that to get... to start making potions. Oh, we actually got it. A gas tier. Amazing. Okay, let's see. Now, I think that I should kind of tunnel back up again because that's where I can see most of the area. And I'm trying to find these nether fortresses. I'm trying not to stay too low down. It's much better to find them higher up because that's where they usually spawn. Around areas of, like... Around areas where there's a bunch of lava down there. They can spawn there. I saw them spawn like that very often. So yeah, looks like there's nowhere to go over there. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have such an issue of finding the nether fortresses like I did in the Skyblock series, so it's gonna kind of suck. Okay, let me just explore this area real quick. Doesn't seem to have too much content in it. Okay, we are running out of torches. I should have brought more stacks. Okay, well, there isn't really much to do here other than to collect this glowstone and quartz here, so I guess I'll just push on down there. So now I have to come up with a way how I can get down here without actually getting any fall damage, so I guess staircasing down would be a good idea. Okay, that's still a bit too steep, so let's hope that we can staircase down further. Okay, now I guess we'll have to start placing blocks down so that we could staircase down like that. I'm gonna jump down right here. Place some more blocks like so. Now there's lag spike or something. Okay, now let's... I really hope that we can find some nether fortresses in the near future because, it's really gonna suck if we don't, so that's I really hope that we could find some more nether fortresses because that's what I'm really here for, and I want to explore many nether fortresses, and it's quite difficult finding them, so I don't really know how I'm gonna go about all of that, but I guess I'll have to look around and see where I can find one. So maybe there might be one some kind of lake over there, a lava lake, where there would be some another fortress hanging off there. Okay, let me just put some torches right here. Okay, there is a lava lake there, but of course no nether fortress so far. I am having immense difficulty in finding these nether fortresses. Well, what I think I'll do is that I'll go off camera and I'll just find another fortress in between episodes. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please stay tuned, I'll make much more episodes in the future. I'm gonna go and explore some more nether fortresses, possibly find one. And in the next episode, if I do manage to find one or two, I will show you them and show you all the areas that I already explored. I am running out of torches, so I'll probably have to go back soon anyway. So, this was Minecraft Lix, thank you very much for watching. See you all in the next video.